Hi, I'm Jim Luby. I'm on the faculty in the Department of Horticultural Science at the University of Minnesota, and I've been involved in conducting apple trials at the North Central Research and Outreach Center for some 20 years now, at least. And today I'll summarize some of my observations. First of all, I'll start out with my favorite apple variety in the trial that we've looked at, and this is the variety called Zestar. In our trials, this has been very hardy. It has an annual crop. It doesn't go biennial. It's relatively early ripening, and then it has, most importantly, very good eating quality, pretty good storage ability, and excellent cooking quality. In fact, in our house, it's our preferred apple for apple sauce, apple pies, apple crisp. So really, as an all-around favorite, this one has probably stood out for amongst all the varieties we've tried. Now, along with Zestar, there have been three other older varieties that have been reliably hardy at the North Central Research and Outreach Center orchard. All of these are very early ripening. They're all older varieties, kind of classic varieties. All of these varieties are good early apples, but they won't store a long time, so they do need to be eaten or used for sauce or other things very shortly after they're harvested. Next, I've got a list of what I call moderately hardy varieties. These generally have survived well, but they will have some winter injury in some years in our orchard. And this includes a lot of our University of Minnesota varieties. Honeycrisp falls into this list, as does Harrelson, which is an old favorite, certainly. And also Chestnut, which is a small, edible, very edible crab type, Keepsake, Frostbite, Sweet 16, and State Fair. And then one I've added to this list is an old Minnesota variety, although not from the university, Wealthy, which was probably the most popular variety in Minnesota back in the late 1800s and early 1900s. And then I want to talk about varieties with some truly outstanding hardiness. And these have shown no injury over the 20 years that we've been testing them. They're just rock solid for winter hardiness. So for really cold sites, these are really some apples that could be useful. These are all what we might call edible crab apple varieties. They're certainly not the ones that your birds feed on, but they are larger and somewhat tastier. Centennial itself is actually a variety that's quite nice to eat. And finally, one of the things that we hope to learn from these variety trials is what doesn't work so well. And here I am listing several varieties that have been relatively winter tender in our orchard. They can be grown, they will last a few years, but they tend not to last too long in our climate in north central Minnesota. So these are varieties that I would probably avoid unless you've got really a very favored site, or if you really want to have one of these because it's your favorite.